Well, hello everybody. I wanted to discuss in this video the actual actual post that's just Tony Atwood's put on his webpage, and this is about the it's about relationships or something or other. It's about love and family and Asperger's. Now, I posted on Dr. Tony Atwood's website and Facebook page as well because I was diagnosed by Dr. Tony Atwood. And I posted about my renewed faith in finding love through God and through a relationship in my own faith with God. I don't know whether Tony Atwood's Christian or not. When I last spoke to him, he just didn't really sound like he wanted to speak to me when I was saying about his son, you know, give him some comfort about it. He just wanted to brush me away. So, you know, if the leading psychologist of Asperger's brushes me away, who else can I turn to? But can turn to the Lord to get a sense of renewed faith. So anyway, what I wanted to discuss in this video was the difficulty in that with the human condition, in that people write me off because they don't understand me, but my developing faith in understanding God and having a renewed sense of having a connection with God and through Jesus and so forth. Now, this video, once again, is my own words. It's not about converting anybody. It's not about offending anybody. I'm going to quote three bits of scripture, and it's up to you as to whether what you make of them. I'm just going to quote the Bible. I'm not going to interpret it. I'm going to quote the Bible based on experiences that I had today. First of all, I'm reminded in Ephesians 4:18. Now, Ephesians 4:18, chapter 4, book 18, discusses having their understanding darkened, being alienated from the life of God because of the ignorance that is in them, because of the blindness of their heart. Now, today I was sort of rejected by another person, on the grounds that this person said, I have my own friends, I don't need your friendship, and I don't really, and he unfriended me on Facebook. Now, to me, yes, I found that quite hurtful, but I just thought, well, really, as it says in this passage, that Ephesians 4:18, having their understanding darkened, being alienated from the life of God because of the ignorance that is in them, because of the blindness of their own heart. And verse 19 says, who being past feeling, having given themselves over to lewdness, to work all uncleanliness with greediness. Now, for people that reject, I wonder if they, when they reject, are they also rejecting faith in themselves? Why do people reject others? And this is something that the Bible quotes us in this particular passage. And to me, I think it's not my loss, it's their loss, you know. And I draw comfort in the word of the Bible, because when I get uncertainty in my life, I can quote scripture and I can say, well, this is what I believe God is telling me or is guiding me in my own thought process. Now, I don't want to get too bogged down in this bit of scripture. I'm also wanting to read to you James chapter 1, verses 2 and 14. Now, James chapters 1, 2, 14. James 1, 2, 14. 2, 4, sorry. My brethren, count in all joy when you fall into various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience, but let patience have its perfect work, that you may perfect and complete, lacking nothing. This is a quote I wanted to apply for people that are feeling often frustrated in their lives. They feel that there's a sense of having no direction and no purpose, and working hard and wondering where their life is going. The Bible actually quotes that bit of scripture, and I will just read it again. So this is James 1, verses 2 and 4. My brethren, count in all joy when you fall into various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. but in patience. Let its perfect work, that you may perfect and complete, lacking nothing. So that's a quote I wanted to use for people like students that are perhaps feeling frustrated and a sense of a lack of purpose or a lack of direction in your life. This is what God says in the Bible. This is what the Bible actually says. And this is why I say to students, encourage students to just learn some scripture. Because, you know, if you have doubt in your own abilities and in your own direction, why not look at the Bible and look at what the Bible has to say? Just pick up passages. Pick up scripture. Do a search on Google and look up scripture and see what the Bible has to say in relation to these challenges that you may often confront. The last bit of scripture I wanted to quote today was Hebrews 13:5. Now, I'll just read that passage for you. So 13:5, let your conduct be without covetousness. Be content with such things as you have, for he himself has said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. So we, in verse 6, so we may bodily say, the Lord is my helper, I will not fear. What can man do to me? Now, that I assume is Jesus actually talking in that last passage. You have to understand that in the Bible, Jesus was tested many times. You know, Jesus was taken to the cross, of course, and he encountered difficulty in the Easter message coming up. I mean, I think John actually quotes the book of John quotes the crucifixion. And talks about, and I have to actually go through the scripture and be able to find that actual passage that relates to crucifixion. But, you know, if Jesus really lived, and I believe he did live, imagine what it was like for him when he went to the cross. You know, he was there and he was judged before Pilate and before Herod. And, you know, they wanted to have Jesus replaced with Barabbas, and Jesus was given a horrible death. He was beaten, he was whipped, he was spat on. Everything you can think of happened to him, and he was taken to the cross. Oh, he took himself to the cross. He's whipped as he's carrying the cross himself. It was actually a black man that helped him take the cross to where he's going to be crucified. I think this is a message that we need to remember on Easter, that we need to actually go back and understand what happened with Jesus, what actually is the true symbolism of Easter. And I think that in those other passages I read, we can get tested, and the world is a very testing place for many of you. I know many of you that are, I know many people that are students, I know many people that are working, I know that the world is just so brutal at times. And what can we do? What can we turn to? And one of the things we can turn to is we can turn to Scripture. And the Bible is the best way we can understand the Word of God. There are people that may not believe that. They may have their own opinions about it. But to strengthen faith, and that's what it's all about, is faith. About building faith, strengthening faith, and testing faith. So many young people today feel frustrated, feel angry, can feel confused about life. And simply, all it really needs to do, and I mean, the Bible is not a boring book. It's just a matter of actually going and just studying some scripture and just reading some passages in the Bible, getting some Bible groups going to church, questioning, asking yourself, what exactly is the Bible about? You might say it's a boring book and it doesn't interest you, but how do you know if you actually haven't read it? How do you know when there's been no real interest in you in reading the book? So I'm going to, when I can, do some more passages and more. I'm going to do some sermons or whatever. They may not be that great, but I'm just trying my best to get the word out there. So I hope today I've been able to say something. Thank you very much for watching.